Okay, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Today we are going to start the course that is about data communication and data communication and computer networks. It is also called DCN. Okay, so its course code is CSC339. Introduction about me: I am Nader Shah and currently working as associate professor at Kamsets University, Islamabad, WA campus. Okay, so before starting this course, what are the requirements? So first of all, the syllabus or the course outline, it will be given to the CR. Moreover, it will be uploaded via CO online, so you can access it from there. And this is a tangible outline, so maybe we can update as we cover different topics. The rules and regulations: since you are fourth semester students, so it means that you already know the rules and regulation of Kamsets University. So for that purpose, those rules and regulation will be strictly followed. In the class, we must have a CR. Okay, so one of among you will be selected as CR. So the CR is responsible for class arrangement, for class makeup, any other activity, all the communication between me and your class, it will be done through the CR. So if you want to approach me, so you must approach me through your CR. In this course, 80% attendance is mandatory. Okay, so make it sure that your attendance is more than 80% in the course. It is desired that you must have strong programming background with the but it is not necessary that you must have programming skill in a particular language, but you can have, for example, it is open. If you want, you can do network programming in Java, in C++, Python, as well as in any other tool you like. And mathematics background is desirable. It is not mandatory, but if you have mathematical background that can help you to solve the advanced topics, so they are given in the exercise in this book. So, but it is not mandatory. The mathematics background is not mandatory, but if you have, then it will be a plus point. In this course, it is assumed that the students, they know a little bit about computer networks, because for example, all of you, they are using smartphones, so they are using internet, so they know about what is internet. Okay, so this background is necessary. Otherwise, in this course, we will try to we will start from beginning. Okay, from the beginning of what is a computer network and how it works. So we will start from the basic topics of computer networking, but at least the student, they should know about the what is internet and how internet works. Okay, so but I assume that all of you are using smartphones and you are familiar with the internet, so I think you must have this knowledge. Okay, so the course assessment will be announced by the university, so we must have to follow those university rules and regulations. For example, there will be some quizzes, four quizzes, four assignments, and the sessional exam, it is not yet confirmed, but anyway, if it is announced, then we will have sessional exam, and the terminal exam or the final exam, it will be mandatory. Okay, but along with these things, I also have a class project. So you will have a class project, its marks will be 20, but they will be distributed. Okay, distributed means that in the first sessional, so you will have some marks, in the second sessional you will have some marks, and then in the final term you will have some marks. And this class project, you must have to presents your idea, your projects, by doing some simulation or by developing an application or implementing a protocol. It is by static, it means that it is desirable that in this class, if you want to understand and practice the protocols that you will learn in this course, so you must have to develop an application. So when you will develop an application, so those concepts of the protocol, they will automatically be understood by you. Okay, so it is it is also very good if you can prove some the working of some protocol application through mathematical analysis. Okay, so these are some of the projects topics that you can search and you can select as a class projects, including, for example, you can develop a peer-to-peer application, you can develop a group communication service, you can develop naming service, green networking, etc., etc. You can work on the green networking. Okay, for example, in computer networks, they also use energy. Okay, so how to design the protocol that are energy efficient, that can contribute to that are environmental friendly, that can improve the environment. Okay, so these topics, they will be discussed in the course, and then you can take them as your class projects. Okay, so when we will study any system, for example, whether it is a computer network or whether it is a software system, any system that you are studying, when we design a system, so we have to evaluate its performance. Okay, so when any system is designed, okay, so when any system is designed, okay, so we must have to evaluate with whether this design is correct or not correct, and then if it is correct, whether it is efficient or not efficient. Okay, so to evaluate any system, so okay, so we have different options. Okay, for example, one is that we prove them a system mathematically. Okay, that okay, it is correct, it is efficient. Okay, so if you can we can prove it mathematically. Similarly, in the computer networking, you can prove the correctness, the efficiency of a internet application or a protocol, that whether it is working correctly or whether it is efficient or not. So you can do it by using some mathematical analysis. Okay, so if you prove something mathematically, then I think it is most perfect way of evaluating. Okay, but it is very difficult. Okay, so there are some tools which so you can have another approach, that is called simulation. So there are different tools available for simulation, for example, NS3, Mininet, OpenNet. So in these tool, you can implement your protocol, you can implement your application, and then you can run. Okay, and then you can see that whether it is working correctly or not correctly, efficiently or not efficiently. So this is another way of simulation. So there are different tools. Okay, NS3, Mininet, OpenNet, these are the tools, and there are many other tools available for different purposes. Okay, so you can also do simulation is a class project by using these tools. Okay. Another thing is the test bit. It is a before discussing the test bit, let me discuss experiments. Okay. So another way is the third way of evaluating the performance of your system is to deploy it experimentally in a production network. For example, in Comsat's internet. Okay, in the Comsat University, we have a production network, the network, and it is running. Okay, so you can put your application, your protocol, and you can test it in the experimental, in this experimental network. Okay. But it is very, very difficult. It is not affordable because if you implement your work in the Comsat University internet, so definitely our administrator Wahid Zab, they will not allow it. Why? Because he will think that, okay, my internet is working. If you want to experiment your application, your protocol, maybe it can affect the network performance. Okay, so any network, any organization, they don't want to allow anyone to have experiment to perform experiment in their network. Okay, so we can have a test bed. Test bed is a experimental network, but it is at a small scale. Okay. So you can run your, you can have your routers, your application, your servers, your switches, your access point, etc. And then you can test, you can your application, your protocol in this test bed. And you are fortunate that it comes at University Islamabad. Comes at University War Campus. I have a test bed. And we have some switches that are SDN switches and as well as legacy switches, routers. So we have a SDN testbed available. And in this SDN testbed, we have open daylight controller. And they are it is installed, it is working, and all the routers and protocol are working. So if you want to run your protocol, your application that are SDN application, so you are welcome to use my testbed. Okay, so it is available at my lab. Okay, so the motivation, what is a computer networks? Okay, because this course is about data communication and computer networks, so first of all, what is a computer network? Okay, so before discussing what is a computer network, why is computer networking so important? Why is internet so important? What is its importance? So to discuss the importance of the computer network, let me give you some examples. For example, how many people of you, they are familiar with the WWW web? Okay, so you have WWW web. So this protocol, it is used to access the website. So for example, yahoo.com, google.com, any other website, zameen.com, etc. So all these websites, they are accessed by using WWW web. Okay, so nowadays you can buy buy anything on the internet. Okay, you can order them. Okay, you can search on the internet for a particular research paper on a topic. Okay, so all these are the applications. Similarly, you must have to be I think you are familiar with the familiar with the streaming applications. For example, this is a streaming application that is to watch movies, to watch, to listen to the music, etc. This is the a Skype application. Okay, Skype application, and you are this is uses for internet calling, audio video communication, conferences, etc. And this is the Facebook, so social networking. For example, Facebook is used to for social networking, and it is very famous. And I think any every student among you, they will have a account here, okay, and they are using it. Similarly, the YouTube, you can have you can watch movies, you can also have to there are different lectures uploaded. Even my channel is there and I'm uploading my lectures there, video lectures. So the YouTube is a streaming service available, okay. You can similarly the cloud computing, okay, you are storing your data in the cloud, and okay, so and you can access them, okay. You can also run your application, your on the cloud, etc. So it means that if you imagine, these are some few applications of the computer networking or internet, okay. So if by assuming these application, by how they are important, are very very important. If the Facebook is blocked in the Pakistan, how many of you will be feeling sick, okay? So it means that, so and nowadays the and each and everything is relying on the internet, on the communication, okay? So it means that it is very very important. If there is no internet, then there is no life. It is not true, but it is can be assumed, okay? So it means that the internet computer network is very very important. So that's why this course is important. This course is also important, okay? So what is a computer network? Computer network is basically the network, or it is a interconnection of different devices, communicating devices. The communicating devices, they can be laptop, mobile phone, a car with the internet, a router, etc. Okay, so connecting more than one communicating devices with each other, this is called computer network, okay. So we will study how this computer network is built up, okay. It is a very abstract level. Now we are going to discuss in detail what is a computer networking, okay. So in the computer networking, basically the user, they access the internet or the computer network by using applications. So different applications are running over the these devices. For example, YouTube applications, Skype applications, Skype server, YouTube server, Gmail server, etc. Okay, so so internet or computer network is a, it is a connecting more than one communicating devices. When more than one communicating devices are connected, they becomes, it becomes computer network, it becomes the internet. And the user use this computer network through applications, for example YouTube, Facebook, Skype, okay. So now we will start chapter number one. So up to now we have discussed the general overview of the course work, okay. So in the next video we will start chapter number one, okay.